reasons why, you know, we should completely shift to electric vehicles and do away with any other means of transport.
Sure. So if you look at any of the newspapers, we are in Delhi right now, and the discussion is mostly on pollution. India has 13 of the 20 most polluted cities in the world. So to improve the health of our citizens, we definitely have to make this happen in terms of electric vehicles. So that's the first and primary reason. The second reason is we are at a point in history where electric vehicles are cheaper in terms of total cost of ownership compared to an internal combustion engine. So if you ask me this question 5 years ago, we weren't at a stage where we could say that in terms of TCO, total cost of ownership, electric vehicles were cheaper than internal combustion. So right now we are at a stage where it is cheaper to use electric vehicles than petrol or diesel powered vehicles. And the third reason is India wants to become a manufacturing hub in electric vehicles. So India is the leader in terms of two-wheelers and three-wheeler segment vehicles. We export our products not just to developing countries but to various developed countries as well. So to secure the future of manufacturing jobs in our country and to gain the expertise as well as ability to export our two-wheelers or three-wheelers to other parts of the world, we need to invest in electric vehicle manufacturing, invest in business models that that enable electric vehicle ecosystem, the swapping stations or charging stations. So that will make us future ready for dominating the two-wheeler and three-wheeler market segment specifically. So in terms of manufacturing, so the government has come up with 5% GST on electric vehicles, which is fantastic. So it's a very good positive move from the government. So second thing, they have introduced two-wheelers and three-wheelers in the FAME scheme. That is also a fantastic move from the government. They realize that it will be the two-wheeler and the three-wheeler segment that will get electrified soon, rather than and the rest of the segments will follow later on. So in terms of one of the key gaps that we have observed, not in terms of government but in terms of the financing of electric vehicles. So the banks are unwilling to finance electric vehicles because they haven't seen the track record. And to be fair, the banks have actually funded some of the low quality electric vehicles that have come up a few years back, and they are skeptical because of that. So the what we are asking the government is to have some kind of loan guarantee mechanism which will make it comfortable for the banks to basically fund new products developed by startups like us. So in our case, if you look at any of the established players, so for them it's a small portion in their grand portfolio of products. Electric vehicles is one small portion, but for a startup like us, it's about survival. So once we are moving from hundreds of vehicles to thousands of vehicles, this key financing, vehicle financing, electric vehicle financing is one key obstacle that we are facing right now. And we are talking to various banks and government to come up with a loan guarantee mechanism that will make this happen. If you asked me this question 3 years ago, I would have that doubt. Would we be able to compete with larger players? But having interacted with them over a period of time, having competed with them on a daily basis over a period of time, having beaten them, some of the very well established manufacturers over the 2.5-3 years time frame that we have, I'm confident that the electric vehicle revolution will happen because of startups. It won't be the large established players which will be driving electric vehicle adoption. It will be the startups which will be driving electric vehicle adoption. So if you look at the market in US, it was Tesla which had to drive this adoption. So the large established players are like dinosaurs. They take a lot of time to move. And in a field where you need to keep changing, keep updating on a daily basis or on a monthly basis, the reaction time is very slow. So for example, one of the feedback from Big Basket, one of our customers, is that if we tell Gaia Motor Works to change something, so that it becomes easier for adoption of electric vehicles. They come back with a solution in 3 months. But if we do it to the larger company, which has also sold some vehicles to Big Basket previously, they haven't yet come back. It has already been 2 years. So in such a fast changing environment, for the large established players, EV is a small segment in their grand portfolio of things. For us, it's about survival. So our existence depends on getting market share of electric vehicles as much as possible. So it will be the startups which will become big and force the established players to come into electric vehicle segment rather than the other way around.